basketball tonight. Prairie Grove girls and boys will be facing the Huntsville Eagles. I'm Lynn Gregson, and my sidekick tonight, Chad Battles. And Chad, this is first time. It's going to get used to a new partner. We had Derek Dugan, obviously, for years since we started the webcast. And now, Chad, you're filling some big shoes, but you'll do it just fine. How do you feel? I mean, here we're in the new gym. You had the opportunity to play on the, I think you graduated with 2011-12 team. What do you think about this new gym?
See, this compared to especially the old one, it's pretty spectacular to be able to see all the changes. So it's pretty cool to see it.
Well, tonight's contest, our girls come in. They are the defending conference champions from a year ago. The defending district tournament champions, the defending regional champions, and so they come into the game trying to seal another one. It's funny, our girls over the last 7 years have captured the regular season championship in every year but 2014. That's fairly impressive, isn't it?
Yeah, no, that's quite amazing to be able to see that consistent effort in winning that many games over the years. It's pretty amazing. And what's cool to see is, especially with this Huntsville girls team, I mean, they have their own track record. They have a history of themselves, you know. And so it's going to be interesting to see these two teams.
They always play each other really hard. Over since 2010. Now, Huntsville hasn't always been in the conference. They kind of go up to 5A, come back down. But they've only beat Prairie Grove since 2010 one time. That was in 2015. They won 40-38 at the old Prairie Grove gym, and Prairie Grove got revenge later that year. But it's always a close battle. It's always a fight, and Huntsville's known for their basketball, both girls and boys. And so I think tonight will be nothing short. You know, Prairie Grove got off to a win, a 42-34 victory last Thursday against Greenwood right here on this floor. But this means a little bit more to them.
Yeah, and talking about just the history of these two teams going back and forth in the past, I actually found out that the overall record between us, we played 24 games and we're tied 12-12.
Wow.
So tonight's going to be interesting. It seems like we kind of have that even matchup over the years. We've been able to give, you know, both teams a run for their money.
Well, it will, you know, and that 12-12 split is almost a run. It sounds like from probably about 06 or so till 2010, it was all Huntsville. And then the tables turned. Prairie Grove won the state championship in 2010. Since then, it's been mostly Prairie Grove. So, you know, you're right. Tonight, kind of, is it a new time for Huntsville to start, or is Prairie Grove going to continue what they've been able to do the last several years? Another interesting thing, Chad, and we'll probably talk about this several times throughout the year, because there is a change in the way that the conference is being done. Now, the conference will be the same that we had in football and the same we do in other four sports, the conference tournament. The conference tournament will be Huntsville and Berryville. It will be Gravette and Gentry. It'll be Pea Ridge, Lincoln, Prairie Grove, Shiloh. Those eight teams. But the district that we'll be playing in during the regular season will be a split between 3A and 4A. Those teams that we'll be playing in our district will be Elkins, Gentry, Gravette, Greenland, Haas Hall Academy from Fayetteville, Lincoln, Pea Ridge, Prairie Grove, Shiloh, and Westport. When the season comes to a close, Westport will go to the 4-4A for their tournament. Elkins, Gentry, and Greenland Haas Hall Academy will go to the 3A, and then Huntsville and Berryville will join the rest for our tournament. So a little bit different than we've had in the past, and that's the AAA trying to cut down on some travel and things like that. So while these two teams will probably face each other in a tournament later down the road, not really a conference game tonight, but it'll feel like a conference game because they've always played.
Yeah, it's interesting to see how that's split up, because that's, you know, 3A and 4A teams. And Huntsville's kind of jumped up to the 5A, but come back down to the 4A. And so that's kind of interesting to see how they're going to compete with those teams as well.
And I didn't mention that, like I said, Greenland will be the other team from there that will do that. And the thing that's interesting, and it's going to be interesting, Huntsville really needs to get a feel for night for where they are, because they're going to be playing, and I don't mean this in disrespect, but they're in a District 2, and in that District 2, they're playing a lot of 3A schools, so they're not going to get as clear of a measuring stick for just how good they really are or just how much far they have to go. So let's get ready here.
Before we have our starting lineups, let's please rise for a moment of silence, followed by the singing of our national anthem and the Prairie Grove alma mater by the Prairie Grove Tiger Honor Choir. A moment of silence.
Starting lineup from there.
Now our starting lineups, first of all, for the visitors from Huntsville. Number 12, Gentry Gosfiner. Number 23, Delaney Tipton. Number 34, Catherine Walden. Number 2, Michaela Watkins. And number 4, Macy Campbell. Head coach of Huntsville's Charlie Berry, assisted by Greg McCone and Christy Song. And now for your hometown, the Lady Tigers. Number 4, Audrey Doring. Number 10, Lexi Maywell. Number 20, Camry Bartholomew. Number 22, Cassidy Sapp. And number 35, Emily Grant. Head coach of the Prairie Grove, Kevin Proud. Assistant coach, Shelly Dugan.
Okay, I'm back with you. Right now, Chad had to step away for just a bit. We had a slight technical difficulty, so we will be working through that. I will be calling the play-by-play now until we start, or until Chad's able to come back. Jumping for Huntsville, number 23, Delaney Tipton, and she gets the tip. So here come the Lady Eagles. Long three on the way, no good. Rebound goes to the Lady Tigers. That's number four, Audrey Doring. And quickly comes Camry Bartholomew. Lexi Madewell, now it's Cassidy Sapp. Long three, no good there. And now we're going to have a foul. It's going to be on Doring. First team foul for Prairie Grove, first foul of the game on Doring. Lady Tigers in the man-to-man. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Sapp fighting for the rebound, and wow, that was tipped at the last bit there by number three for Huntsville. I'm sorry, that was number two. That is Michaela Watkins. And now, ooh, boy, Prairie Grove may have gotten away with a walk, but nonetheless, retained possession. Sapp, the ball at the top of the key. And Bartholomew looking, trying to find it. There's Sapp for three. Bottom! There we go! What a way to start! Hey! Cassidy Sapp gives the Lady Tigers a 3-0 lead as we have 6 minutes and 27 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Waldron feeds inside, and it's a foul as Tipton goes up. Cassidy Sapp gets her first foul. It's the team's second. And Tipton now trying to tie the game. Goes off the back of the rim. A rebound. It goes out of bounds. That was off of Lexi Madewell. Well, no, they're going to say it went off the Huntsville player. So Lexi brings the ball in to Bartholomew. Bartholomew trying to get her a shot. There's Sapp. She's trapped in the corner there, and now she gets it away just in time. And Bartholomew kind of tightropes the out-of-bounds line and stays in bounds. And now there's Bartholomew. Long three. No good. Rebound goes to Tipton and the Lady Eagles. 5:40 to go. 3-2 Prairie Grove leads. Tipton looking inside. She feeds it outside. Three-pointer, and it's good. Three-pointer by Catherine Walden. And the Lady Eagles take a 5-3 lead. Here comes Bartholomew quickly down the court. It's stolen by Tipton. She was looking for Doring. Tipton intercepts the pass, and now Lady Eagles on the attack. Walden again. She gets to Campbell, and Campbell hits a three. So Macy Campbell hits a three, and it's a 5-point lead for the Lady Eagles, 8-3. Madewell gives the ball up to Sapp. Sapp now top of the key. Oh, tries to feed inside, goes off the foot of Tipton, and the Lady Eagles have the possession. 4 minutes, 30. There is, well, I thought that Lady Eagles can get another three off, but that would have been Campbell again. Campbell does take the three, and it's good. That's 2 threes in a row by Campbell. And Prairie Grove's going to take a timeout. They're down 11-3. And the Lady Eagles have now jumped out after hitting three three-pointers. Have an 11-3 lead. Prairie Grove's only basket coming from Cassidy Sapp. .424 to go here in the first quarter. And now pressure in the backcourt by the Lady Eagles as Bartholomew's trying to get it over. She gets it to Madewell, who gets it over the timeline. There's a three-pointer by Emily Grant. No good. Rebound's going to go to Campbell. I'm sorry, that is Watkins with the ball. Trying to get his eye to Tipton. Does. Nice feed, and Tipton gets the easy basket, and it's now 13-3, a 10-point lead here in just 4 minutes into the game for the late long three by Bartholomew. No good. Rebound goes to Campbell, and boy, the Lady Eagles have a chance to really stretch it out. And Sapp trying to get a steal. And cross-court pass. Waldron gets it there. It's Campbell again for another three. No good this time. Rebound goes to Tipton. No good. Rebound's going to go in the hands of Emily Grant. 3:14, 3:13 to go here in the first quarter. Lady Tigers, they've had some shots, just haven't been able to hit yet. And now Bartholomew drives, no good. Rebound goes to Delaney Tipton. She gets it over to Watkins, and the Lady Eagles are back on track. Campbell again for three. This is going on, not even going to hit the rim. Knocked out of bounds by Tipton. 2:49, 13-3, and Chad, you're back with us here.
Yep. Being able to see just, I mean, right out of the gate, just really hitting on all cylinders for Huntsville right now.
And Lady Tigers is not able to hit. They get the rebound. There's Sapp for three. No good. Ball goes out of bounds.
And that's hard for Cassidy. She looks a bit frustrated just because she knows she can hit that shot.
And for Huntsville, number 15, Darian Solbridge.
And so we've seen already by number four on the visiting team, Maddie Campbell, she's hit a couple threes. Hopefully our threes will start hitting.
Number 15 now in the game for, that is Suffrage. And now Lady Tigers with the ball. Got to get some points on the board here, Chad. Just, we've had some shots, just not able to convert.
Yeah, no, it seems like we're just maybe a bit hesitant right off. We're taking the shots, they're just not going in. And I think the opportunity's there. They've been open a couple times.
We have taken a couple of deep threes, but Bartholomew's been known to make those. Madewell with the ball. 1:40 to go here in the first quarter. Lady Tigers down 10.
And we see that driving kick and
ball knocked. Wow, that is good defensive play there by Gosvinner.
Got to be careful on that backside. They're
trying to get it attempted. They do, and she's unable to. She gets her own rebound, and she gets a third shot. This time, no good. So, man, can the Lady Tigers get out of it? They're going to get the jump ball here, and they're going to get possession. Man, you got to get those rebounds. Tipton got three shots and right close, so we're fortunate she didn't make it. Coming into the game now for Prairie Grove is number 12, Larisha Crawford.
Something I already notice is, I mean, with number 23, Delaney there, I mean, that height difference down low.
And she has gotten several rebounds and got several chances that last time down the court. Prairie Grove needs a basket here to close this quarter. Grant with the ball. She gives it to Madewell. Madewell.
The Huntsville Eagles, they're playing tight defense on us right now, not giving us any space.
And Eric, I'm sorry, Chad.
Bottom, there we go.
As Lexi Madewell knocks down a much-needed three-pointer.
And that's a bit of a breath of fresh air right there.
It really is, Chad, because she, boy, we got the first basket in a, within about the first minute and a half, and then we went 6 minutes without a basket. Tipton at the free throw line.
Just as tight as they're playing defense on us, we are as well. We're in that tight man defense.
Campbell, three, no good. Rebound's going to go to Grant. She gets it off. No, it's going to be short. Well, that's going to do it for the first quarter. After one quarter play, the Huntsville Lady Eagles 13, the Prairie Grove Lady Tiger 6. We'll be back after this.
Let's face it, the internet has become part of our day-to-day life. You find your news there, you pay your bills there, you do some shopping there. And on the internet, with PG Telco, you got a lot of things on your side. First of all, Zing Broadband, moving at the speed of life. And then there's the 110 years of experience you get with PG Telco and a 24-hour repair service guarantee that you may not find elsewhere. So be it your home or your business, PG Telco has you up to speed with Zing Broadband. Connect fast with us. Call 479-846-7200. 479-846-7200. PG Telco, moving at the speed of life.
Everett Chevrolet, proud sponsors of Prairie Grove High School Athletics and also proud of their huge inventory, both new or used. You'll find what you're looking for at Everett Chevrolet. Are you looking for the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size truck on the road? You're looking for the Chevy Silverado, and they've got them. How about the Chevy Camaro? How about the Chevy
Okay, we're back with you, and Chad, it doesn't happen often, especially our home gym where Prairie Grove gets down 10. But they got down 10 quick, but the three-pointer did close the gap. And now Lady Tigers, a couple defensive stops and a couple of baskets to get right back in it.
Yeah, you can kind of see the similar technique of the running of the, you know, type of plays, you know, tight defense, man-on-man, that pressure. They can hit the outside shot. It kind of looks like a two-mirrored style system, you know. Oh, and they brought the backside with Camry now.
And now kicks it out. That is Suffrage for three, and she knocks it down. Suffrage knocks it down, gives Huntsville a 10-point lead again.
And it's hard to bring that back door to try and get that down low secured. That's hard to do without leaving someone open.
Now there's Grant for three. No good. We got to knock those down. Oh, we need those. We need those with those. That was an open shot. I know we can't make them all, but when you're down 10, you really need to try to hit those.
It's true. Every shot at this point, playing from behind, every shot's crucial.
Yeah, you can't get forward, especially a team as well coached and as good as Huntsville. You're not going to be able to get too far behind. Of course, Prairie Grove's been here in the past. There's a three-pointer on the way from Huntsville. No good. And quickly down the court comes Crawford, lays it up. She's going to be fouled. Shot last time was by Watkins from Huntsville, and then Crawford gets the quick rebound and down. She gets fouled. She'll have two shots.
Foul on Huntsville, number two, Michaela Watkins. Crawford at the line, shooting two.
And this is something we need. We need to stay strong on our free throws, not playing from behind.
She hits the first one. She makes them both, does Crawford, and now it's 16-8. Nicely done there by Larissa Crawford.
It's interesting. You see, they've got that swinging.
And Watkins misses three and another. I'm sorry, Chad, look at that quick rebound.
Oh, wow.
You were saying, Chad.
Yeah, they've got that. They swing the pass up on the top really quick. It's hard for our defense to keep, you know, that kind of adjusting to it.
We lose the loose ball there, and now Huntsville back on the attack. 16-8.
Hopefully we can keep that down low secure.
Watkins looking inside for Tipton. There's a three-pointer on the way, and it's good. Another basket by the Lady Eagles. That was number 10. That is Courtney McCone that made that. It's an 11-point lead for Lady Eagles.
Back in the play, girl, number 22,
Grant. Grant's going to come out. Sapp's going to come in. Sapp's a senior. Bartholomew's a senior. Crawford on the floor is a sophomore. Doring's a junior. And Lexi Madewell, a sophomore. So two sophomores, two seniors, and a junior for the Lady Tigers. Sapp goes, takes, almost gets the and
one. We needed that roll there.
19-8, Lady Tigers trail, 5:51 to go in the first half.
Something I'm seeing here already, they've already made 5 3-pointers, so 15 of those 19 points are 3-pointers.
Sapp misses the first of her free throws. She knocks down the second one, so she goes 1 of 2. That makes Prairie Grove 3 of 4 from the free throw line. 19-9, trailing by 10. Gets it inside, tipped in. Nice job by her, but she's unable to convert. And there's Crawford boxing out well to get the rebound.
That was a good box out down low by Crawford.
Crawford not that big, but able to get the rebound. You know, Prairie Grove's replacing, you know, essentially three starters and their fourth person that came off the bench from a year ago. A lot of them has playing time. There's a nice take by Sapp, unable to go. And now we're getting a jump ball here. Wait, are they going to call a foul? They're going to call Sapp for the foul. What I was saying is you're replacing a lot of you're replacing the Harton twins. Ashley Cox from a year ago did a lot of inside work. And then Taylor Dawson came off the bench. So
this could be kind of a new feeling for them to start out the game and be at this place. Replacing a lot of experience.
Tipton gets this one. It's 21-9. Here comes Bartholomew. So now we got a 2-on-1. Bartholomew takes it all the way, and they're calling a blocking foul on Tipton. Tipton's got 6 points in the game.
Way to go in there strong.
Huntsville now has 4 fouls. Prairie Grove has 2.
Our free throws, that's a strong, I guess, part of Coach Proud and his coaching. He's always wanted to be solid on free throws, so that's good to be able to lean back and see that.
And the second one on the way, in and out. So Bartholomew makes 1 of 2. Prairie Grove now 4-6 from the line. 21-10, Lady Eagles leading the Lady Tigers.
Oh, almost there on that pressure.
Campbell took a shot, got her own rebound.
And we're kind of in a bind right now because we don't want to give away that 3 point, but also we don't want to give away the down low. So we've got to find a way to, good defense.
Yeah, you're right, Chad. Doring is fighting hard inside there against Tipton. Tipton's at 5'8", and Doring 5'6", so she's got a couple inches on her. But Doring's doing a nice job, good front, but Tipton makes the basket. It's a 13-point lead. Bartholomew quickly gets it down the floor. Long three by Bartholomew, no good. Rebound goes to Tipton. Coach Froud.
Man, it can get frustrating. You can get frustrated with yourself as a player, you know, if you keep shooting them and they're just not falling.
They're moving the ball around, gets it inside, tipped in there, some backside help. They're going to get it for a walk. Should. They're going to call a foul on the floor.
Yeah, they got us on a foul for that.
Number 10, Lexi Madewell.
That's Lexi Madewell. That's her first foul, team third foul. I thought they were going to get tipped in for a walk. She kind of shuffled her feet inside.
Yeah.
I guess they're going to get a push now. Just like that, Madewell picks up 2 quick fouls.
Foul on Prairie Grove number 10, Lexi Madewell.
It's hard because whenever you can kind of see that size down low and the different sizes, whenever you're a bit, compared, you're a bit smaller, you want to get a bit more aggressive. You know, you want to start using body.
They're going to get tipped in that time for blocking foul on Maidwell. That's her second, the team's fifth. So 3.5 minutes to go here. Now coming in from Prairie Grove, number 11, Madison Hartgrave. 3:31.
They're coming with the full court press already. And that was good on us to be able to stay calm and get it past half court.
Yeah, we did beat the press. Now Hartgrave with the ball. She takes, pulls up, shot on the way, no good. Rebound, gonna go. Gonna be a jump ball, and Prairie Grove has possession arrow this time. 23-10, 3:06 to go here in the first half. Coming into the game now, number 50, that's Lily Eaton.
For Huntsville, number 50, Lily Eaton.
Tipton's going to come out with those two fouls. And Bartholomew, and then she's going to get fouled. Fouls on number 34, Catherine Walden.
Fouls are piling up just right here in the latter end of the second quarter here.
You're right, Chad. And that's six fouls. So Prairie Grove will be in the 1-1 on the next foul. And they're going to get in to Crawford in the backcourt. She's going to bring it across. 3 minutes to go here in the first half. Prairie Grove trailing 23-10. Bartholomew there's Goring with the rebound. So Prairie Grove gets possession.
And I think they're gonna take advantage of, I guess, these fouls right now. Camry just drove there, and that's a good decision to try and draw the foul since they have so many fouls already.
Now gets it to Bartholomew. She throws the three up. Bottom! There we go. And Bartholomew makes the three. She closes the gap to 23-13. Boy, we need a stop. And stolen by Bartholomew. Bartholomew going to take. Drive. Goes up. No good. I think she anticipated a little more maybe contact there. And
yep. I think she was trying to get it.
And Prairie Grove, after that exchange, missed that time by Campbell, and Hartgrave gives it up to Bartholomew. 2:15 to go here in first half, and Lady Tigers trying to close this thing down within striking distance.
They're going to set up the offense. Coach Froud giving the calls out for what they're going to do.
Now here's Crawford. Oh, almost loses it. And Coach Froud not happy with that. Long three. Whoa, that was a long one. And a long rebound goes out. And Bartholomew knocks it away. Almost gets another steal. 23-13. Lady Tigers trailing. 1:38 to go. Gottsfeeder. Back into the game. Watkins with the ball, and there is shot on the way, no good. And the rebound, nice job by, and a walk, and we get a break right there. They got a rebound, but then Mason Campbell walk, Lady Tigers get the ball.
And that was looking scary right there because they just had an open three, luckily. A bit of an air ball and then kicked right back out and down low, so it looked a bit worried there.
Gets it to Bartholomew there, trying to trap her on the far side. Bartholomew dribbles through it, and now she gives it up. There's Grant. Grant kicks it out. There's Crawford for three. Bottom! There we go, 23-16. And Crawford closes it to seven. That's the closest Lady Tigers have been in a while. Minute five to go here in the first half.
And that's what we like to see. We're used to seeing that kick out, pass, and shoot.
Cross-court pass. Watkins drives. They're going to call a blocking foul on Dory. two shot. Michaela Watkins to take a couple free throws for Huntsville. First one's on the way. No good. 23-16, the score remains. 50.8 seconds to go here in the first half. Second on the way, and it's good. So 24-16. And here it comes. Bartholomew breaks it down. We got numbers. Gives it up to Doring. No good. Got to have that one. Doring goes back up. She's going to get fouled. Wow.
That was a fast-paced, good dribbling and pass by Camry just down low. And you kind of just hope, you're just there and you want it to go in. But good for her for drawing the foul, getting their ball back.
And she banks that free throw in. I heard a call.
I called it. I heard it.
She said glass. She said glass. 24-17. Doring with a second on the way, and it is good. 24-18, Lady Tigers, after being down as many as 13, only down six. Need a turnover here, and maybe could close this gap a little more before halftime. Been a little bit different game as Tipton's been out.
Yep, we don't have to really put that pressure on the backside.
And there's a three-pointer, and the rebound goes to Bartholomew. And we got time, 20 seconds to go here in first half. And now Grant with the ball. She's picked up by Gosvinger. She's going to get fouled. And we're going to get a one-and-one for Grant. So we can close it here, Chad. She can knock these down. We're going to be within
four points.
And like you said, Lynn, it's been a different game with, Delaney Tipton out. You know, she's accounted for eight of the points, but she's a presence down low that you have to account for. You really got to – they're bringing someone backside, and they don't have to do that when they're in.
Speaking of Miss Tipton, yep. She just came in. So 14.5 seconds. Grant coming to the game or from the free throw line. Shot on the way. She's got it. So 24-19. Lady Tigers have battled back. And coming into the game for Lady Tigers, number 21, Kaylee Elder. Misses a second, so 24-19. And now Tipton with the ball. Prairie Grove needs to keep them from scoring. They get the ball to start the second half, or that possession arrow. So, and they throw it. Oh, I thought it was going to be thrown away. They got it. It's a two-point shot on the way, and it's good. At the buzzer. Nice execution there. That was Courtney McComb.
That was just a good backdoor pass there. I didn't even think it was going to get there.
I thought it was going to go out of bounds, but they make it, so it makes it 26-19 to end the first half. So scoring first for our Lady Tigers. Audrey Doring, two free throws. She's got 2 points. Lexi Madewell with a three-pointer. Larissa Crawford, two free throws and a three-pointer. She's got 5. Cameron Bartholomew got a free throw and a three-pointer. Cassidy Sapp, a free throw and a three-pointer. And Emily Grant with one free throw. So Prairie Grove, that's the 19 points for the Lady Eagles. Macy Campbell with 6, Courtney McComb with 3, the Lady Tipton with 8, Suffers with 3, Walden with 3, Michaela Hopkins, 1 of 2 from the line for their 26. Well, that's going to do it for the first half. We'll take a break. We'll be back for the second half in about 10 minutes.
Chevrolet, proud sponsors of Prairie Grove High School Athletics and also proud of their huge inventory, both new or used. You'll find what you're looking for at Everett Chevrolet. Are you looking for the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size truck on the road? You're looking for the Chevy Silverado, and they've got them. How about the Chevy Camaro? How about the Chevy Corvette? It's all waiting for you at Everett Chevrolet. Family-owned and customer-friendly. Everett Chevrolet, I-49 at Elm Springs Road. Everett Chevrolet says, go Tigers!
Who decided you can't have good rates and good coverage? If you're questioning your insurance options, get real answers from a real person. With a Farm Bureau Insurance Get Real review, it's simple, quick, and tailored just for you. Get real auto, home, and life insurance. Get Farm Bureau Insurance.
In Washington County, call Trey Autry at 479-442-4266. Farm Bureau Mutual Insurance Company of Arkansas Incorporated, Southern Farm Bureau Casualty Insurance Company, Southern Farm Bureau Life Insurance Company, Jackson, Mississippi.
David's Roofing and Fencing Incorporated is a locally owned company based in Farmington and has been serving Northwest Arkansas and the River Valley for 19 years. Call David's Roofing and Fencing Incorporated today for a free roof or fence estimate at 479-846-2113. Again, that's 479-846-2113. David's Roofing and Fencing Incorporated is licensed, bonded, and insured. They have an A-plus rating from the Better Business Bureau, and they proudly support all area sports teams.
The internet has become part of our day-to-day life. You find your news there, you pay your bills there, you do some shopping there. And on the internet with PG Telco, you got a lot of things on your side. First of all, Zing Broadband, moving at the speed of life. And then there's the 110 years of experience you get with PG Telco and a 24-hour repair service guarantee that you may not find elsewhere. So be it your home or your business, PG Telco has you up to speed with Zing Broadband. Connect fast with us. Call 479-846-7200. 479-846-7200. PG Telco, moving at the speed of life.
Welcome to Prairie Grove Christian Church, where we're all about loving God, loving others, and serving others.
We offer services on Sunday morning at both 9 and 10:30 a.m., as well as Sunday school for all ages. On Wednesday nights, we offer programming for our children, as well as our junior high youth, and on Sunday night, offer programming for the senior high students. In addition, we host adult small groups in both men's and women's encounters. Here in the community, we give back through the Great Serve, as well as supporting Life Ministries and the Backpack Program. In the fall, we host upward basketball and cheerleading for kindergarten through second grade. This year, we'll have teams of people traveling to both Haiti and Cambodia. So if you're looking for a church home, please come see us at Prairie Grove Christian Church.
Thank you.
Okay, we're back with you about 20 seconds before they get ready to start the second half. Chad, the nice thing is we were down by as many as 13 and able to close that gap down, got it as close as 5, and we ended the half at 7. Unfortunately, they made it right at the end of the half, and they got the possession arrow to start the second half.
Yeah, I think our girls, they're just looking a lot more comfortable. At the beginning, they just didn't look, you know, like themselves. It's a new 5, you know, getting that chemistry, getting the jitters out. So I think they just looked a lot more calm and in their normal, I guess, selves later going on in the game. They kind of focused up and they knew what they needed to do. So they ending that half, it looked the second quarter looked a lot better than the first.
Well, you're right. And now the refs, they had taken a little bit extra time, and they're coming out now. And 29-16. And it looks like Coach Frow, a little upset that we weren't sure if we were on offense or defense. So.
And the question is, this half, you know, are we going to be able to stop the down low game, the low post with Delaney Tipton down there? See if we'll be able to slow that down.
Here comes Campbell. She gives up to Watkins. They're looking inside, Chad. You called it. They're looking inside. There's Campbell. Wide open 3, and she got it. And just like that, we went from being down 5 right before the half to down 10.
And that's hard because that's her third 3. And it's hard to be able to cover both, the outside and the down low.
Just a nice kick out pass. Campbell's wide open, and she knocked it down. And they're going to call a foul on, that is number 34.
Catherine Walden.
It's good to see Grant there to be rewarded with trying to, you know, get aggressive and go the baseline.
And now Lady Tigers having a hard time getting it in, and they're going to, wow, we got a little break there. Just kind of landed. Here's Bartholomew. Ooh, she almost got the 3. And
she
then
thought about it.
Watkins got out there on her pretty quickly. Look, trying to get a little space there with Watkins' attack. And they're
was that?
Wow, she called her for a push.
Wow. Maybe it's the angle I'm at, but I didn't.
I don't know. I didn't see that.
We're trying to get that full court press. We're trying to get that pressure on them before they have the chance to get down here.
And then we're going to need to do that some. Well, we got down within 5, Chad, and they've scored the last 5 points to go back up 10. We've got to hold them. And backdoor pass. And now open shot on the way. Gosvener, no good.
Because it seems like with Huntsville, they'd rather have that set half-court offense. And whenever that pressure starts going in the fast pace, they tend to make mistakes.
Sapp's driving. She's going to get fouled, and that's going to be another foul on Watkins. I'm sorry, that's Walden. I'm sorry.
She, last time she was up at the line, she was 1 for 2.
And this time Sapp misses that first one. Boy, we could just have half the free throws that we've missed, we would be within about 6 or 7 points. We missed a few. Sapp.
Those are opportunities you want to take advantage of. There we go.
She knocks a second one down. 1 of 2, and it's 29-20.
Still keeping up with that full court pressure.
And they're moving the ball around, and it's a wide open 3, and Watkins gives it up to Tipton. I got to tell you, I'm going to tip my hat to the Lady Eagles. They moved the ball very well that time.
That's quick passes, effective passes. That was a good kick, good pass.
Back down by 11. And there's a 3 by Bartholomew. No good. Rebound goes to Tipton. Really, it's what's happened to us tonight. We've had some open shots, just that they haven't gone down. And now there is Campbell for 3. She knocks down another. That's her 4th 3. She's got 12 points. She's the leading scorer in the game, and it's 30. That's the largest lead of the game for Huntsville at 14 points.
And that's the same thing we saw in the last play. Just good court vision, good passing.
Gosfeiner with a foul. And that's going to be Lexi Madewell at the free throw line, and she misses another free throw. So Lady Tigers have missed six free throws, or seven, is it? Let's see, six free throws. So that hurts.
Yep, that's hard, especially whenever those are gimme points.
Prairie Grove takes a timeout. Well, you know, Chad, I made the comment just before the half that we had a 5-point, we were down by 5 points, and they were coming down. And I was thinking, you know, I made the comment, if we could hold them here, because they had the ball to start, you know, they had the possession arrow. They made the basket, and then they made their second one. They're up by 10, and we really hadn't gotten back. Think if they don't make it for the half, we hold them, it's a totally different game. So those possessions, while they don't seem that important, can be huge in a game when you're trying to fight back.
Yep, 100%. Every little point counts. And like you said, this could be a totally different situation.
Well, and you know, the one of the big difference in this game tonight is Huntsville is starting. They start three seniors and two juniors. And we got a lot of youth on our team as Madewell makes the second one. So it's 34-21.
Huntsville is an experienced team. Like you said, they went 19-12 last year, 13-3 in the conference. So they're an experienced team. They played a couple years together now.
And I'm not mistaken, their three losses, two were to Prairie Grove, and Tipton turned around and goes not in. Lady Tigers with the ball. I think they lost two to Prairie Grove, and I believe one to Berryville.
Yep. That was the first game Berryville had beaten Huntsville in 19 games.
Wow. And now nice drive, and good job that time by Emily Grant. Closes the lead back down to 11. It's been as high as 14 in the second half.
They're still trying to double down. And
Campbell, and she's going to be fouled by Bartholomew. Might not have been a bad foul there because she's going to make the basket.
Huntsville hasn't shot that many free throws tonight, just two free throws overall.
First one's on the way, rolls in for Campbell. Crawford's going to come in for Bartholomew. It's 4:28 to go in the third quarter. It's a 12-point lead for the Lady Eagles. Second one on the way from Campbell, and this one falls off the front of the rim. And a 12-point lead. Cassidy Sapp's going to bring the ball up. She drives, takes, no good. Rebound goes to Tipton.
And we're seeing more of that drive and trying to draw that foul. We've got to be careful on that backside.
Campbell, another three, and she knocks down. Another three-pointer.
That puts her totals up to 16 points.
Yes, 16 points in the game, and now a drive on the floor. They're going to call her for double dribble. Wow. The lead's back up to 14. 23-37, Lady Tigers trail. Gets it into Watkins.
And we have no choice but to put some serious pressure full court on them if we want to be able to cut down this lead.
And there it goes. Another basket by Tipton. Tipton now with 12 points, and it's a 39-23 lead for the Lady Eagles. Lady Tigers may have little growing pains here to start the season. They've got some inexperience, and we're seeing a little bit of that tonight.
And I wouldn't discredit this Huntsville team. They're a good team. They've got a lot of experience.
They do, and you know, the Lady Tigers opened up here last Thursday with a victory over the 6A Greenwood team. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound goes to the Lady Eagles, and there's Campbell. She misses the close one, and rebound picked up by Doran, given up to Bartholomew. She drives, goes all the way on Gosvener, and Gosvener fouls, and the ball doesn't go in. 39-23, Bartholomew at the line.
Something we're seeing is the, kind of those loose balls, those balls you need to just box out and get. That's kind of, we're kind of forgetting to do those little fundamentals. Good free throw by Cameron.
Cameron Bartholomew knocks it down. Sapp comes in for Madewell. 39-24. And second one's good. So 39-25, 2:35 to go here in the third.
Got her on that trap, and that's what we're needing.
A timeout called by Huntsville. 2:26 to go here in the third quarter, and this third quarter has been all Huntsville so far.
Yeah, it seems like just right out from the start, it looked like the first quarter again, kind of just hitting on all cylinders. Seen, I mean, a lot of threes. Number four, Maddie Campbell, she's hit five threes. And it's just been a barrage of basket after basket, backdoor passes. It's tough to stop right now.
39-25, and Lady Eagles have possession.
Some of those three-pointers, they weren't close, three-pointers. They were a little bit out there.
I'm a little surprised we haven't put a little more pressure on the backcourt, but I imagine we'll see it full force here soon. There's Campbell, another three on the way, and this time she misses it. Dorn with a rebound. Here comes Bartholomew. Need to make a strong close. Gets it to Crawford. She goes up and good. Larisha Crawford.
You could kind of see Delaney coming down, and she still went up strong and made that.
Wait, did we only get 1 point?
I think you're right. It should be.
I think there's Crawford again, and this time foul. I think we should have one more point. And
foul on Huntsville, number 10, Courtney McCone. Timeout, Huntsville.
We've got a timeout by Prairie Grove here. Matt, that last basket, that was Larisha Crawford. And it kind of looked like the exact same play as before. That was two layups in a row for her. Kind of, we were seeing that hustle from her running down the court. Good court vision to be able to give that pass, to anticipate, to get that foul. So hopefully she'll be able to knock this down. And hopefully this is kind of that turning point, because there's about 11 points, and hopefully we'll see a spark kind of ignited. We'll be able to cut into this deficit here. Lynn had to step away just for a minute. We're just wanting to double check the score, just to make sure. So we're keeping track, and there's a couple other people keeping track. We just want to make sure that all the points are added. This will be Crawford's third free throw of the night. She hit the first two. Just off the back rim, got a rebound from Delaney, and we're seeing that pressure still.
40-29. Gets it inside to Tipton. Nice job by Doring to play D. Unable to stop her, though.
I'll tell you, that's hard.
They're listed like 2 inches different, but it doesn't look like that, does it?
No, it doesn't. It doesn't look, especially whenever with the reach. You know, she kind of looks like she can reach pretty high.
Another foul. Huntsville now with six fouls. Chad, that could help us get back in the game in the fourth quarter. We're now going to be in the 1-1 the rest of the way. Bartholomew's going to shoot two here, so he can get it down to 11. And misses the first one. Ah.
I mean, if we were making these free throws, it'd be...
I believe that's different. Nine free throws that we missed, and Bartholomew makes the second one, so 42-30.
And that's what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to draw those fouls, be aggressive, and slowly chip away at this deficit with some free throws and some and ones.
And a kick out. Oh. Watkins with the ball. 50 seconds to go. Huntsville can take their time with this lead.
And that's why I think they're going to keep looking for the inside, but they get an outside shot.
Watkins knocks down to three, 45-30, and the Lady Tigers, just every time it looks like we may get a little run, they pull away again, and now matching their largest lead of the game, 15 points. Here comes Grant, down, goes up, and in, a chance for the and one. And Grant, get it back down to 12. That's 17 fouls now. What would even be better if we can get it up to 10 to get the double bonus?
That's what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to make these shots and keep getting the and one.
And she makes the and one. It's 45-33. Lady Tigers, boy, if we could get a turnover and get it down to 10 here. Foul on Bartholomew. That's a critical, and that's her third with 15.7 seconds to go here in the third quarter.
It's hard to, end of the game. This is the point where you start getting tired. So to put that full court pressure on, it's hard.
15.7 seconds to go here in the third quarter. 45, long cross court pass. Oh, no.
Campbell.
McCone with the ball, looks inside. There's Tipton. She's working. And they run out of time. Lady Tigers get the ball to start the fourth quarter. They'll have the possession arrow. So 8 minutes left in this ball game. Lady Tigers trailing 45-33.
Welcome to Prairie Grove Christian Church. We're all about loving God, loving others, and serving others.
We offer services on Sunday morning at both 9 and 10:30 a.m., as well as Sunday school for all ages. On Wednesday nights, we offer programming for our children, as well as our junior high youth, and on Sunday night, offer programming for the senior high students. In addition, we host adult small groups in both men's and women's encounter. Here in the community, we give back through the Great Serve, as well as supporting Life Ministries and the Backpack Program. In the fall, we host upward basketball and cheerleading for kindergarten through second grade. This year, we'll have teams of people traveling to both Haiti and Cambodia. So if you're looking for a church home, please come see us at Prairie Grove Christian Church.
Let's face it, the internet has become part of our day-to-day life. You find your news there, you pay your bills there, you do some shopping there. And on the internet, with PG Telco, you got a lot of things on your side. First of all, Zing Broadband, moving at the speed of life. And then there's the 110 years of experience you get with PG Telco and a 24-hour repair service guarantee that you may not find elsewhere. So be it your home or your business, PG Telco has you up to speed with Zing Broadband. Connect fast with us. Call 479-846-7200. 479-846-7200. PG Telco, moving at the speed of life.
Everett Chevrolet, proud sponsors of Prairie Grove High School Athletics and also proud of their huge...
45-33, Lady Tigers, as Bartholomew comes up. Need to get a quick start here in the fourth quarter.
I think utilizing the whole seven fouls would be important.
No good for Bartholomew, a little closer than she normally shoots. And the Lady Eagles will be very picky probably about their shot selection now.
You can see those down low, those opposite screens kick out.
Tipton looking down, and now she gets it up. There's Watkins, a wide open three. That's off. Lady Tigers with a rebound. Coach Froud's telling them to move the ball down the floor.
Ooh.
And there is Doreen, puts it back up and in. 45-35, 7 minutes to go in the game now. Crawford picks up Watkins. Walden now, oh, that's a walk. Yep, they got it. And now the turnover. Lady Tigers.
We're in this game. I mean, 10 points, 7 minutes.
Big possession here. Need to get it down to single digits. Be a great way to start this fourth quarter. Sapp going to be fouled, and now she's going to go up for a 1-1.
These free throws are crucial.
Needs to knock them down. They're at 18 fouls, so after one more, we'll do one more 1-1, and then we're shooting two every time. But, man, right now when it's 1-1, need to knock this down and cut this to 8. Sapp from the free throw line. 6:43 to go in the game. Sapp's no good. Rebound's going to go to the Tigers. And the Lady Tiger, Sapp, gets it back. Almost walked with it. Able to stop there at the last minute. 45-35.
I'm interested to see what offense they're going to run, whether they'll kind of drive it or they're going to keep looking for the outside shot.
Bartholomew for three. No good. Rebound. In the hands of Huntsville, and they get it down the floor. 45-35. And now wide open is Campbell. Misses the three-pointer. And the last time down, we had a free throw and a second shot opportunity. We got to convert those. That's the only way you're going to get back in this game.
We had a defensive stop earlier. We had a turnover at half court. And then here, right here, we just stopped and got lucky by that wide-open shot being missed. So we need to capitalize on some of these opportunities.
Grant comes in for Crawford. We're down to 6 minutes to go in the game, trailing by 10. Need to make. Now Bartholomew drives, and she's going to be fouled. She's going to go to the line. This time she gets two. So from here on out, Chad, we're shooting two.
Yeah, no more 1-1s. They're at, correct me if I'm wrong, but 19 total fouls. So we're in double bonus after this.
And now here is Bartholomew. Gets it in there. 45-36. Gosvener's going to come in the game for Suffrage.
The lead is cut less than double digits.
Yeah, she knocks this one down. It's down to 8. Bartholomew's got it down to 8. And now Lady Tigers putting some pressure on.
We got to be careful to not foul, stay in front of them. I mean, that was a close 8 seconds.
Blocking foul is going to be on Doring. Watkins is going to go to the line. 45-37, 5:42 to go.
Watkins at the line, shooting two.
Two shots, Prairie Grove with 14 fouls, so we got a little ways to go before they're in the 1-1. Shots on the way, no good. So Huntsville hasn't actually lit it up from free throw line either. They've missed about half of theirs. Second one on the way, this one is good, so 46-37. Lady Tigers trail by 9. They've trailed most of the way. They did make the first shot of the game, but really since then have been down.
And I'm sure our girls are feeling that pressure to score quick or to want to cut into this lead.
Can't have that.
And I'm sure they're feeling that pressure. That may have added to it, you know, kind of picking up the pace to want to score.
Coach Froud's going to take a timeout. 46-37. Well, the Lady Tigers not used to being down, and we've seen it. You know, you and I were talking off air a while ago a little bit about Parker Lopez. I believe she still has an injury. She's got a lot of playing time. Coach Froud played about 5 to 8 or so last year. She was one of the ones that got a lot of playing time over as a sophomore and a junior. We could use her. I mean, she's one that kind of slashes to the goal, and she'll take it to the hoop.
Yeah, and she's a physical player. And she's someone that'll get down there and get those rebounds. She'll go baseline. She'll drive. And that's what we need. We need that to open up one of our strong, ways to do that is shooting outside. We want to open up that outside shot.
Well, I'm very impressed with the our younger players, how well they've played. I mean, this is a good Huntsville team. We're within nine and a couple of breaks, and we could get back in it. We're down to 5 minutes. There is, should be a 3 second call. She's been down there for a while. 5:10 to go in the ball game.
And it's just working through those screens. A lot of motion in this half court offense here.
There's Tipton working, and she kicks it out. Watkins, and there is McComb.
So I think they're playing the possession game here.
They're going to make Prairie Grove foul them. And there's a foul by Doring. It's going to be her third foul, team's fifth. Really, if Prairie Grove wants to get a steal, they really need to kind of do it on this inbound, if at all possible. Coming in the game's Crawford. They didn't get her in time. And there's, I talked about the steal, and they're going to call the foul. And that's going to be on Sapp.
I agree. It's gonna have to come in on this inbounds, because Huntsville, we've seen, they're good at passing.
Yeah, we almost got it there.
They're really just rotating around the top.
Really going to have to play tight on this man-to-man defense. They get into Tipton, and they're not going to shoot it. And they throw the ball away. We get a break there. Now, Chad, here's what we got to do. We have to convert here, get this thing down to 6 or 7, and then apply the full court pressure and get the turnovers, because they're not shooting. Unless we get it down to under four, they're not shooting the ball.
No. We got to get it within those numbers and really put the pressure on them to make a mistake.
And now Bartholomew for three, no good. And tough break. We had the look we wanted. Bartholomew may have rushed it just a tad, but not really. It just didn't fall for it. And Bartholomew.
Oh, jump ball.
Jump ball, and the possession arrow is going to go. Well, we get a break right there. Possession arrow is in Huntsville's favor.
Yeah, because we're also now in the part where they're in 1-1.
Let's take a timeout with them. 3:47 to go. Tigers trail by 9.
David's Roofing and Fencing Incorporated is a locally owned company based in Farmington and has been serving Northwest Arkansas and the River Valley for 19 years. Call David's Roofing and Fencing Incorporated today for a free roof or fence estimate at 479-846-2113. Again, that's 479-846-2113. David's Roofing and Fencing Incorporated is licensed, bonded, and insured. They have an A-plus rating from the Better Business Bureau, and they proudly support all area sports teams.
Who decided you can't have good rates and good coverage? If you're questioning
your... Back with you is the jump ball. Possession arrow was in Huntsville's favor. That kind of worked out well for us, because now we have the possession arrow. We're down to 3.5. We're down 9. They're going to be in the 1-1 now as well. We had to kind of foul to make that happen. Boy, she thought about the shot. I think coach would have actually went insane with that long three. Tipton. McCone shoots it and knocks it down to three.
Wow.
That's a big three-pointer. Now we really have to make things happen. Bartholomew's going to get two from the free throw line, 49-37.
And I think that's one of those shots that if you don't make it, coach.
Yeah.
Coach is going to be there.
Back at the Prairie Grove, 22, casting us out. And for Huntsville,
I think that may have been the fifth foul on Watkins. So Watkins done for the night. Bartholomew knocks down the first one, 49-38. This is where make this shot, and then we have to apply the pressure down the stretch here. Second one on the way. It's good.
Coach Proud's yelling,
yep,
get up and get that pressure.
Yep. And tipped and all alone. And now you gotta get a turnover.
Coach Proud's still telling him, you know, to get out on there and get on him. And that's what we're gonna need.
And now you just really, really have to play. And there's Bartholomew. She got the steal. And she got held. Now Bartholomew drives. And she's gonna be fouled.
Good anticipation by Camry, though, on that.
She really
pass.
Got held.
Yep.
But you're right. Great anticipation, Chad. And that's the fifth foul on Gosvener. So they're getting a little bit of foul trouble. They've played about seven or eight girls in the game so far. Suffrage going to come in. Crawford's going to come in for Grant. 2:38. Prairie Grove trails by 10. Bartholomew has two shots here. 49-39. Makes it. Back down to a 9-point lead. It's not insurmountable here, Chad. It's just everything's kind of got to start falling your way here in the next 45 seconds, like free throws. And now this Tipton's not the ball handler. You really want to go after her. And almost gets it, does Sapp.
I mean, this is our chance. We got, I mean, there's 9 points. Oh, man.
And that's going to be Sapp's. Sapp's fourth foul.
And that's 1-1.
They're at the 1-1, so got up. Damn, we have missed 11 free throws in this game, Chad, and that, half of those. Take 5 points there. She missed the front end of the 1-1. This is where if we drill a three or something here, Chad, we're really in it. Bartholomew at the top of the key.
She's got that spin.
Just unable to have it fall for us.
It's hard to see that. She's right there almost.
We're down under 2 minutes to go now, so got to have a turnover, got to have something here, got to get the possession back. Suffrage with the ball, and somebody's going to have to foul here soon. And there's the foul.
Yep, so it comes down to free throws for Huntsville. That's another miss on a free throw by Huntsville. Oh, man. And that was a three missed. We're going to have to foul again. That's Lexi Madewell. She makes her foul. I think that's her second foul.
Well, 49-40. Well, we got the breaks that we need. Missing the free throws, not getting the rebounds. Things just not falling our way, and that one's going to be missed as well. And Sapp gets the rebound, goes off of Tipton, so Prairie Grove's going to have it with a 1:14. Again, not out of the question, but the time is ticking.
I mean, the last 3 1-and-1s for Huntsville, they missed.
Yeah, we have to, if we could even capitalize on those three and gotten 2 points, we were within a three pointer. So three pointer from Sapp, no good. Rebound goes to Tipton, and now down to a minute. That's probably going to do it. So Prairie Grove going to drop to 1-1. Going to be two shots here with 50 seconds.
it was kind of difficult to see some of the, I mean, at times you'd see that spark and you think we're just going to come right back up. But then Huntsville just hit a couple more threes. Put us back, I guess, a greater deficit.
Well, we didn't. The thing we didn't do tonight, a couple times down the stretch here, when we needed those misses, we got them. But what we weren't able to do is convert. We didn't get the rebound, or we went down and didn't make the shot, and down by 10. And now here is Sapp. She takes it, pulls it back out, and it's stolen by Watkin, and that's going to do it as Campbell has it. She'll be fouled by Sapp. Sapp's going to foul out on that. 33.2 seconds. Lady Tigers down 10. So Campbell's at the line shooting two. Campbell with 17 points in the game. Leads all scorers. And now make that 18.
She really hurt us from deep.
Makes them both. So, like I said, Prairie Grove dropped a 1-1 on the season. And long three, no good. Rebound's going to go to Huntsville. And so 15 seconds to go, and the Lady Eagles going to come in here to Prairie Grove tonight and steal only their second victory from Prairie Grove since 2010, the last one coming just a couple years ago in 2015, or the 2015 season.
Yeah, I mean, like you said, these two teams won't see each other again until the tournament.
Yeah, it'll be the conference tournament, as Huntsville will play in a different district as far as district play, but they will be in the same conference when the conference tournament time comes.
I think it's a good learning experience for the girls to look at Huntsville, a good team. We'll see them again. Hopefully see what we can improve on from this. What did we do good? What did we do well with?
I assure you, we'll be working on free throws. But I tell you, Huntsville needs to as well. They've missed a lot of free throws as well tonight.
Yep.
Second one on the way from Sufford. She gets 1 of 2. It's a 13-point lead. So Prairie Grove got it down to 5 just before the half and got it down to, I believe, 8 here in the second half, maybe 7, and then never really got closer than that. Three-point on the way from Grant. No good, and that's going to do it. Final score, the Huntsville Lady Eagles 53, the Prairie Grove Lady Tigers 40. Chad, you want to run through the scoring real quick?
Yeah, so we've got, for the Huntsville Eagles, we've got Macy Campbell with, I think, 19 points. And then we've got Courtney McCone with 8 points. We've got Darian Suffrage with 4 points. We've got Delaney Tipton with
14
points. Catherine Walden with 3. Kayla Watkins with 5. And then for the Prairie Grove Tigers, we've got Audrey During with 4 points. Lexi Madewell with 3. Larisha Crawford with 9 points. Camry Bartholomew with 10 points. Cassidy Sapp with 5. And Emily Grant with 6 points.
All right, well, that's going to do it. We'll be back for the boys' game. We'll come back to you in about 5 or 6 minutes.
You're listening to a broadcast of the Prairie Grove Tigers at pgtigersonline.com.